All right, let's talk about this auntie. This auntie here, I don't know who she is. Some kind of businesswoman, something like that. She left some comments on Instablog Naija. Let me see. Maureen ACC. Who is Maureen ACC? I've never heard that name before. Let me see. She sounds like somebody that everybody knows somewhere, but let's check. I'm just Googling. That's all. Okay. The only thing that comes up is this content. Some Ghanaian lady. Okay. She's been having opinions online. Okay, I guess. Well, she has opinions about marriage. So let's talk about it really quickly. Let's see. She's giving advice. Okay. I don't know if she's married or she's not married, but she's giving advice. Let's go through it. She said, this is for those of you looking for a life partner. Anyway, before I continue, hold on 1 second. For those of you looking for a life partner, stay tuned. She has advice. Okay. Hold on 1 second. Gracious greatness. How far, my guy? How you there? Anyway, so let's get into this story. This is for those of you looking for a life partner. Choose good, genuine character over religion. If you doubt this, ask people who married their spouses solely because they are pastors. All right. That's cute. Okay. That's cute. A good advice. Take it. Run it to the bank with it. Okay. But character, it depends on what lens you're looking at character from, right? But nonetheless, let's not discount it. You should look for good characters. Okay. But to compare that against pastors, I'm not sure what she's getting at here. Let's continue. Secondly, she says, don't overlook bad behavior in hopes that they will eventually change or you would change them. That's true. That's a good one. You cannot change human beings. Either you've been married to them for long or just fresh. It doesn't matter. They are who they are. They will evolve in their own way based off of the environmental influences, cultural influences, the way they were raised influences, the future we're heading into influences, social media influences. They will evolve, right? And you can't change whatever it is that they're showing up as. The only thing you can do is influence, because you're a powerful influence in their lives, because clearly you married each other, right? You made them marry you. You made them get into a relationship with you. You have some kind of power of influence over them, okay? But not change. You can't change them, okay? The third one says, have sex with your partner before walking down that aisle, because trust me, a flaw in this is gigantic enough to make you walk back up that aisle. If you have to have sex with people before you know you're romantically or sexually attracted to them, you're lame. Let me repeat. Now hear me. So you guys hear me. Hear me very well. Okay. If you have to have sex, now I'm not an advocate for either one. You know, honestly, I'm not that religious, okay? But let me make this clear. If you have to have sex with people before you know you are sexually attracted to them, you don't know what you're doing, okay? All right? There are people that have been married to people for years upon years. They've had sex, they've had children four times. And they claim that person never made them come. Shout out to this lady, Yao Mattel, Melody, on this show on the OWN Network. They have 4 children together. They were power couple everywhere. She said he never made him come. Okay. After how many sexual encounters do you think they had to have 4 kids in all those power couple marriage? Exactly. So, dear, you know, those advices, slow down, auntie. She said, have sex with your partner before walking down that aisle, because trust me, a flaw in this gigantic, like, if you have to have sex with them, like you're lame, and you shouldn't be talking about marriage. I'm just letting you know right now, okay? Because that angle you're entering with marriage is wrong. Pardon my manners, let me read a couple of continue before I continue. Nicole says, getting clear on what you control and what you don't. Write a list. You can't truly control another human being. Once you realize you only control yourself, your response is yes. Absolutely, Nicole. That's very, very true. It's white, I wonder, is what he's doing on a Nigerian blog. He likes brown sugar. You forgot that part. He's looking for brown sugars. Okay. This auntie continues, understand each other's love language because it would highly improve communication. Communication is vital for a lasting union. The till old age kind of union. Okay, we can take that. Okay, take that. The next one says, be you a housewife or a working one, learn to save for a rainy day. Okay, what she's trying to say is save for the day when you want to exit that marriage. Okay, if that's how you think, you will end that marriage with your own mindset, your own hands. You attract what you fear the most, because that all that energy you're putting into that mindset can be put into learning how seduction works for both short and long term, so you can actually create the experience you're looking for. But you will always create the experience you're looking for. That's precisely what I'm saying. You know, it's kind of like what some of the things you will read in the book, Number One Red Flag. You will always create exactly what you're looking for from a mindset standpoint. Okay. The next one says, okay, let's go on to the next one, next slide. There is no gold medal for the one who marries the earliest. Wait for your time and for financial stability. This is usually a useless, not all the way, half useless advice. And here's why, okay? People are going to marry at their time as a default, okay? That's just what it is, okay? Every marriage is such a powerful thing that I'm not sure anybody is really orchestrating at an intentional level like that, okay? But we can be intentional with the work we put into ourselves, so that when you do attract marriage, you are attracting a healthy relationship, a healthy situation, no matter when that is, okay? So you're worrying about somebody waiting for their time, or they stole somebody's husband, like, I don't know how useful that is for anybody, especially if they've made up their mind already that they're going to do what they want to do, you know. But I guess it's cute on paper. Yeah, wait for your time. Sure. And for financial stability. What the hell is that? What is financial stability? If you live in the Western world, if you're an average person that lives in the Western world, what is financial stability? Let's be frank with ourselves. Right? They literally designed this system for an average person to never have financial stability. It's an extremely hard thing to do. It is doable, okay? But it's very likely by the time you're figuring that out, there's a season of your life that's on the other side. You know, you're waiting for perfection before you do marriage. Baba, you go collect. It doesn't exist, okay? The cards you're dealt with, that they dealt today, what do you do with it? When you're faced with crisis, how do you react? When you're faced with conflict, how do you react? These are the skills you need, okay? And all of that has nothing to do with financial stability, but everybody wants to talk about money. I get it, because money is everyday part of our lives, right? I get it. But this is why you have money, you become the richest person in the world, you still end up in divorce. Did I make that up? I didn't.
Different from Bala Blue. Bulaba.
I did not make that up, I promise, okay? You can go and look at it. The richest people in the world today, okay? Waiting for financial stability, waiting for their time. I'm not sure how useful it is. It's half useful. Let's just give you that, okay? There's no perfect advice anyway, right? I'm just trying to get you to think about these things. That's all, okay? Somebody say, have a small memorable wedding. Rather spend that bulk money on a fantastic honeymoon and the first years in marriage. They are the hardest years because no one care after your wedding day. Ah, cute. I'm not sure what that has to do with marriage, but I agree, because I think the world is moving in a direction where people will stop spending all that money on weddings, okay? But that has nothing to do with the health of the relationship, the underlying relationship in the wedding. It has nothing to do with it. Now, it could be a symptom. It can end up being a symptom. You might point finger at it's because we spend all that money on wedding. But no, there's other foundational issues that created the demise of that wedding earlier on. Report your partner to their family members if you must, and not yours. That's a common sense advice. That's a common sense advice. She said, report your partner to their family members if you must and not yours. You would eventually forgive them. Your family member will not. That's true. That's true. Your family members will not. They will if you forgive. You have to give them time. They do. Everybody do forgive. Everybody does forgive at some point. But that's a function of you forgiving your spouse. They don't really have a choice if you're moving forward with your spouse, right? But again, that's common sense. Let me know if my mouth is mismatching my video. I think it should be fine. Let me check actually. It is actually. Hold on 1 second. What's wrong with this thing? What is wrong with you? Let's try that. I think it should be fine now. I don't know why it does this. Okay. Let's see. Are you with me? Let me see some of these comments. Okay, hold on 1 second. All right. Pardon me. I just always like to make sure you guys are having a good experience. All right. Let's see. Sex is teachable. Let's get that clear. I don't think he actually have a choice overall. It's something you're going to have to learn to be better and better with over time. All right, let's just go ahead. StreamYard is acting up. All right, so I don't think good point not to, because you're gonna have to learn to be better with that. Given, I don't care how many people you had sex with before you got into marriage, there could be 1,000 body counts. When it comes to long-term relationship or any particular person, you're gonna have to learn how to take care of them in that department. So I'm not sure what people are looking for, but that's a good point not to. Yeah, anyway, so let's continue this hunty's advice here. So that's a common sense, reporting to any family members in general is highly discouraged. I discourage it. If you don't have any choice, you can't afford, you can find somebody who is wise, that won't take sides, that can listen to, actually take the time to listen to what's going on and not feel the need to take sides. If you know such a person already, sure, you know, but it's preferable that you find people that don't have any default bias. Family members in general have a default bias. It's either they want to support you or they don't want to seem like they're supporting you, which is still a bias, okay? And if you can afford to avoid that, just avoid that. Again, part of your skills is to actually learn how this work at a level of at a skillful level, not just somebody taking your sides or helping you scold the other person, helping you put your partner in their place, right? That's not what you're looking for. You're looking to learn the skill for yourself to nurture, to give into that relationship if you're already in it, okay? And I'm not talking about extreme situations now today, okay? If he or she hits you before marriage, they will hit you after. That is it's not a fact, but let's take it as a fact, okay? Why would you want to take the risk of finding out later? Maybe they will hit you again. I don't think it's worth it. It's a lot that happens in the mind of a person before they actually leave their hands and hit you. If that's happening so fast earlier on, yes, we can guess that. We can just basically assume that they will do it again, okay? But it's an assumption. That's all I'm saying. But it's an assumption worth... Take the advice, okay? In marriage, love is 2%. Wait for this one. This one is interesting. In marriage, she says, hold on. Marriage is 2%. Okay, oh. No, sorry. In marriage, love is 2%. And then the person goes on to say, friendship is 38%. Tolerance is 60%. Hold on 1 second. It's going to put that on the screen. Marry your friend. I love you isn't 100% valid reason to get married. Now, I agree, okay? But everything she said is inside of love, the true meaning of love. Okay, so love is always enough. It's just a very it's dangerous to run around the internet streets and say love is not enough. Okay, I will do a whole, I might even write a whole book on it, okay? And I'll give you tons of stories why it is just dangerous to run around the internet street and tell people love is not enough. If love is not enough, nothing, not even friendship will be enough. There's a place of friendship inside of love. There is no, the only need that people have to say love is not enough is to make it feel better or sound better. You're still moving with your feelings. Love, the one that is enough, is not just a feeling. Feelings are part of it. Any type of love that discounts feelings is not love either. But love is a whole lot of things. It's like trying to put God in a box. Think about God is love, right? Whenever somebody says love is not enough, they are literally saying God is not enough. I get it, there is a context. They're trying to say love as a feeling is not enough. Okay, then say it out completely, because love is such a powerful word by itself that I'm telling you, when you say it, the other person is interpreting what you said based off of their own definition of love, not your definition of love. So while you might mean well when you say that, you might just be creating other types of damages in people that are impressionable, right? I just want us to be careful with that. God is enough. So love is enough, okay? If you need to learn the full, holistic, everything that's inclusive in love, then let's do that, okay? But I don't think it's helpful to just feel good about yourself as another mentor on this internet street and say love is not enough. I just don't think so. And I'll prove it later on. I know it's going to take me time, but I'll prove it, okay? But tolerance is inside of love. Friendship is in love, okay? Marrying your friend is part of that formula, okay? And yes, it's a formula, right? I love you is a valid thing to say. When people say that, you need to value it and not water it down, okay? Now, if their behavior is not matching the fact that they love you, then address the behavior. Don't worry about Well, you can call them a liar if you need to call them a liar, right? But please don't turn that around and say love is not enough and say love is 2% instead of marriage. That is a lie from hell. Love is everything, everything. Okay, love is giving, is grace, it's all of that, it's patience, it's love, it's kindness, it's all of that in Corinthians and more. And that's not a religious talk. It's, I want you to know that there's more for you to do when you find yourself inside of Boto. Okay, you find yourself in crisis. I want you to know that there's more work you can do, right? And the more you embrace that idea, right, the higher the reward will be, right? Because everybody else, guess what they do? They quit. Prematurely, okay? And some people rightfully quit when it's just abusive, and they should, okay? But so a lot of people are just, they take some of this small rhetoric, they flip it around, they turn it to ideology, they turn it to a religion, and they live by it. And then they're collecting breakfast because they say love is not enough. You collect breakfast from 30 people, you become a red flag for the marketplace. It doesn't matter what side you fall on. You can be the collector, you can be the giver of breakfast. If you collect enough of it, you become a red flag. Anyway, this auntie continues. Marriage isn't for everybody. We agree. Women, men, money indeed stops nonsense. She's talking to both men and women. Money indeed stops nonsense. No, it doesn't. No. If we're going to generalize that statement, money does not stop nonsense. In fact, money can actually attract nonsense, because when you have money, you get a certain level of attention, and that can attract a certain level of nonsense. To whom much is given, you never heard that before. Much is required. Yeah, if we're going to generalize that statement, it is wrong. Okay, money does not stop nonsense. Okay. Then she said, that you got pregnant for that man isn't a valid reason to marry him. I agree with that. Don't marry because you got pregnant. Just take care of the baby. Okay. That lady got pregnant for you isn't a valid reason to marry her. I agree with that. If you meet the I'm saving myself for marriage people, run. 95% of them is a blatant lie and a trap to get you to marry the devil that they are. Virgins don't collect. Oh,
hey. Sorry,
terrible. It's a terrible advice. Again, the fact that you're a virgin has zero connection to anything that has to do with your skills with long-term relationship and marriage. Zero. For or against, okay? Why they need to generalize people that are saving themselves for marriage? If they're saving for themselves for marriage, I think that's applaudable. I think that's honorable. Now, a person that feels the need to demonize that, that's a red flag. That person is a red flag. Okay? There's nothing good in that, okay? She said it's a blatant lie. She generalized. Probably because she found a virgin that disvirgined her and then she's mad at all the virgins now. May God save her. Anyway, she continues. Avoid men, women who have a problem with being disliked by people who do not matter, i.e. it's important to them that they are liked by everyone. Run. They will never protect you or your home. That's a lie. We all care about what people think about us. It's only if it's chronic. It's like a chronic urge, or let me say a chronic, what's the word I'm looking for? Need for validation from other people, right? But we all enjoy people validating what we say. All of us, we do, okay? So again, generalization. And you know how I feel about that, you know. But if they are coming off as obsessive and they need everybody to like them, I get it, okay? But that's not necessarily a red flag. It could just be a personality trait. You might need to get to know them a little bit more, right? I'm not see how relevant that is, you know. Do you like me? Okay, now, there is something, okay, just to be fair to this person, there's something in our poisons list here. Not the poisons list, the anti-seducers list. It's called the number 5, the bumbler, the weird self-conscious. If that person is always like, did I offend you? Like, they're obsessive in that way. Yes, that's definitely an anti-seducer anyway. I wouldn't need to tell you that you don't like that. But if I need to tell you you don't like that, maybe it's not really a big deal. Like, don't let people just project on you anyhow, okay? All right, let's see. Auntie still continue the advice. Women never let... Okay, so this person... Okay, she continues. Avoid men or women who do not have love or respect for their mothers. There is no valid reason for that. Okay, there are many people who have disdain for their mothers and there are valid reasons for that. Okay? There are valid reasons for that. Okay? Now, avoiding them... I mean, what do you mean by avoid? Right? So, because if you're already into them, you might not even listen to me avoiding them. But in general, I think it's a healthy thing for people to have good relationships with their mother. But I'm not seeing it as that simple of a stuff. I'm seeing more and more examples of people that have a traumatic experience with their mother and they feel some type of way. Now, in terms of learning how to communicate that without coming off as a red flag, that's something you should pay attention to. You know, so I'll take it in. I'll take it as a pass, okay? Be careful. Be careful with people that don't like their mothers, okay? Just be careful because the problem with that is that we're not saying their reasons are not valid. That's the part that I disagree with. There are many, many valid reasons. But when people hate on a particular significant person in their life, they often don't always know. They don't always know when to stop the hate. You might just collect in that process, okay? You might end up on the receiving end of that as well. That's why it's very important to, be careful with that, you know. That's why hating people in general or it's just a bad idea, because even you, that you're hating people, you don't know when to stop. Anything that looks like that person you hate, you will start hating it. Or you're coming off as you're generalizing, or you're blocking everybody into a box, right? It's not healthy for you or the other person or people. There are people in your life that you have relationship with that will end up on the receiving end of something they have no idea what you're dealing with, right? So in that respect, I would say she's half right and she's half wrong. She's wrong about the fact that there's no valid reasons. There are valid reasons. She's right about the fact that you should be careful with them. She's half right, because she said avoid. Be careful with that. If it's a person that's working on themselves, then you're going to need grace too, at a large extent in life, right? All right? So clearly, Sean doesn't watch my show, because she's trying to call me right now. Anyway, women, never let your man know your financial worth. She's advising women for marriage. Yo, listen carefully. Yo. Women, never let your man know your financial worth. No matter how much they love you, they are designed to never be okay with it. It's an ego thing. It's not your fault or theirs. All right, that's a nice, cute way to add, because I do that too, you know. To say, okay, it's not your fault. All right, great, right. If you are married to a person that doesn't know your financial worth, get out of that marriage immediately, with immediate effect. Why? Because you will call it. It's gonna come back and bite you in the butt in ways that you don't see it coming. It's gonna come from a blind spot. It's a dangerous game to play. Clearly, you don't feel safe and secure in that marriage. Why are you inside of it? You don't have to make a permanent decision, but maybe you should back off of the marriage for a second and figure out why you don't feel safe with that person. This is a terrible advice, okay? Transparency in marriage. Ha! In the same breath. The next one is transparency.
Jesus is Lord.
Transparency in marriage sometimes is unhealthy. Oh, okay. It still aligns. Mumbe. Transparency in marriage sometimes is unhealthy. Keep your mouth shut. I don't think that's a healthy advice either. Now, there's something called selective honesty. Selective honesty is not about lying to your partner or the people in your life. It's about timing. It's about timing. There's certain information that you just don't give within. Just because I'm blunt, I'm just going to tell you as it is. Right? There's something called timing in the game of life, in the game of romantic relationships, in the game of seduction. You have to understand timing, right? But just outrightly keep your mouth shut indefinitely, that's not healthy. Why are you inside of the relationship? Jesus Christ. Well, maybe because I have 4 kids and I have 3 kids again. You can back off for a second and figure out what's going on so you can actually enjoy the relationship, right? Why would you want to be in a relationship you don't enjoy? Back off for a second, figure out what's going on, right? Before you move forward. As opposed to lying to yourself that, you know. Anyway, let's continue. She goes on to say, choose your battles. Construct your words properly before you utter them. I can rock with that. That's social intelligence. Divorce on the grounds of adultery is a sin. What? Divorce on the grounds of adultery isn't a sin. Divorce isn't a sin, period. Okay? Divorce is not a sin, period. Right? Let's continue. Let's not waste time again. Be sexually compatible before you even consider marriage. That is a false advice from the pits of hell. Sex inside of a marriage, if you know what you're doing, gets better with time. Okay? Now, obviously, it's some kind of bell curve. After a while, it gets better with your experience. I'm not talking about better with the experience of the other guy who thinks you're not having good sex, but you feel like you're having good sex, right? But for you, right? For you in particular, sex gets better with time, including when you both are sinking together and you don't really have it as much anymore because you're doing like this around. You're like 75 years old. You have it every now and then. You still enjoy it together. It gets still better because you're having it with your favorite person, right? It gets better with time if you know what you're doing, okay? But the idea of looking for it to just be compatible in the beginning, this is the beginning of failure in a relationship. This is how you start to fail. Now, you should be sexually attracted to your partner, Okay, I do think you should have that from the get-go. But compatibility becomes questionable when you find yourself in crisis. Have you ever spoken to anybody who is having trouble in their marriage right now? One of the first things they say is, I don't think we are compatible. Like, oh, now you just found out you're not compatible. Thank you for telling me that you're going through troubles in your marriage. It's a fancy way to say that we're struggling in our marriage. That has nothing to do with compatibility. It's something that every marriage will go through. Now, the question is, do you have the skills to kick in at this point in time when you're going through this, through the crisis? You probably don't. Like the rest of us, when we find ourselves in it, we didn't have it, you know. Shout out to Ebi. Ebi, my G, what's going on? Good to see you, Ebi. All right, let's see here. So the compatibility thing, be careful. All right, when people, if you're not talking about compatibility in the beginning, before you actually see finish, then it's not compatibility anymore. There's a crisis going on, and if you run to the other side of the streets because you think you avoid your compatibility, you'll find your compatibility there. Okay, it's like a shadow. It follows you everywhere you go. It's you. It's not your fault, but it's you. Okay, she says, do not marry a liability for the sake of love. Well, most people that are marrying people think they're marrying an asset, so I'm not sure how useful that advice is. Respect is an important, is as important as food is. Okay, we agree with that. To be spelled that out earlier, we're not saying specifics, just mutual respect, of course, right? Your mother-in-law isn't your mother. That is false advice. Your mother-in-law is as good as your mother. It's a mindset issue. If you have this mindset that your mother-in-law is not your mother, you know what time it is. You will collect. If you disagree with me, be patient. Time will tell you, okay? Time will tell you, all right? Your sister-in-laws aren't your friends. Same thing. It's a mindset, okay? If your sister-in-laws are your enemy already, I'm not talking to you. But if you're leading with this mindset, you will create what you fear the most. Because we are human beings. We have an incredible radar for bullshit. We can smell it. We know when you don't really feel like we're your friends. So guess what? Let's match energies. That's what they say, right? Let's match it. It's not always intentional, okay? All right? But, you know, equilibrium, you know, the water will flow to balance itself out. If you already have that mindset that your sister-in-laws are your enemy, it only makes sense that the universe will agree with you and help you create it. Right? Aha. I know. Hola. No, but yeah, just wait. Be patient with yourself. Okay? Your domestic staff have no business having direct access to the man of the house. Well, if you have a domestic... I don't know what this has to do with marriage, first of all, but, you know, it's maybe in Nigeria. If you have to monitor the access of your domestic... Why don't you just get rid of the domestic staff? Okay? It's crucial to understand each other's life goals before venturing into the union. Life goals is a moving target. It can change. This is a terrible advice. Respect each other's privacy. I agree with that. As long as they're not moving mad. If they're moving mad, it doesn't make you feel safe and secure. You can't respect it. It's impossible. Right? You'll be snooping around like, what are they up to? Now you start to feel like it's secrets. So again, this is one of those issues that people address, like they're addressing it, but they're not really addressing it. It's privacy is questionable already. To them, it's just a secret you're keeping. So it's a problem that you're going to need to address at some point, and you can't run away from it. Yes, even if your partner is the one perpetuating it, that is effectively your problem to resolve at some point, at least help resolving at some point. Never marry a partner who is answerable to no one. I agree, especially if they are not answerable to a higher self, God, right? Money is important in marriage. Money is important in life. And then this person goes on to say, above all said, don't get married. It's like no wonder. It's like no wonder. Said, don't get married. All right, now I'm looking at something here. Don't say, my mother-in-law. Hold on, 1 second. Hold on. All right, so let's see here. I'm looking at some of the comments here. My mother-in-law is my mother, and my sister-in-laws are my sisters and friends. That's a good point. That somebody who understands how life works. Somebody who is not measuring life off of their limited common sense standpoint. Okay? She lost me at there's nothing like a good marriage. Oh, she said something like that. I missed that. Oh, there is more. Wait till there's more. Wait, there's more. Let me just, I think it's the last slide. Okay. So there's nothing like a good marriage. LOL. No one is a robot. They only just master the art of endurance and tolerance. And understanding that love isn't just a feeling, but a decision. All right. Again, they always mix 80% of truth with 20% poison. Pay attention to that. People that mix 80% of truth with 20% poison. Pay attention. Those 20% are good enough to destroy 80% of your experience. You know, Pareto rule. Yeah. I guess she was responding to someone that said, are you real or just joking? You don't think some people got lucky, blessed with a good marriage despite the challenges as expected? There are good marriages. We'll call it good marriage because overall it's good. Doesn't mean they didn't wake up one day feeling funky. All right. And then somebody said, ever been married before? Somebody asked. And then she goes, yes, dear. And really, I don't need to be married to have sense. Hey, I knew it. I knew this was all coming from common sense. I just knew it. When I hear common sense rhetorics, I just can feel it. I lived with a married couple for 35 years, my parents. Lobato. You can't make this up. You can't make this up. So in all of that, which one do you agree with? Which one do you disagree with? I wonder if there's anyone you agree with. If there's anyone you disagree with. I just wonder. All right. But let's do this. I'm going to leave this here. All right. So let's do like this. We're going to round this up today. It's 12 minutes over time. All right. I want to say thank you to all the Obodo fam people here. I appreciate you for coming, for stopping by. Always appreciate seeing you all. Shout out to Auntie B. I appreciate you, Auntie B, for coming by and sharing your gems. Unfortunately, because she was rushing, she's on a mission to, she has some advocacy programs for domestic violence and stuff like that. We will talk about that more as time goes on, but I definitely want to be in support. I'm in full support of whatever she's up to with regards to that. And I can't wait for her to take off with our programs in Nigeria and stuff like that. So I want to say shout out to Auntie B for the £50. I appreciate her for that. I guess she's launching her book today. Shout out to Natu. I appreciate you for the $20. I appreciate you. Thank you guys so much. I appreciate you. Hopefully you've been enlightened and educated. I'll see you on the next one. Peace. Your love that I've been missing. I miss all your hugs, your touching and kissing. Me love on the floor, the couch in the kitchen. One love enough, we done enough.